thank you for logging on to this virtual session, the third, I believe it's a third room. This afternoon, I'll be speaking about the Philippine IT BPM industry, and we'll present a presentation on how our world-class services forge the way to the future, no, of this industry. So first slide in. Okay, so the IT BPM industry through the years started in the Philippines in the 1980s with basic encoding, in-house development, and programming. More than 30 years down the road, the industry now offers more complex and varied services that go beyond traditional call center work and utilize digital platforms and solutions. It is considered as the country's largest job generator and one of its biggest private sector employers. The Philippines is the world's second largest IT BPM market after India in terms of headcount. We are a preferred third-party service provider and an integral part of the global services delivery landscape. Companies partner with us to develop domain expertise, niche capabilities, and attain competitive advantage, as well as to leverage and quickly build digital technologies and capabilities to remain agile. Currently, there are around 1,300 IT BPM companies in the country with competencies in contact center, F&A or financial and accounting services, IT and software development, engineering, and multimedia. Next slide, Tin. So what is our competitive advantage? So these companies, among others, set up or located in the Philippines because of some very key competitive advantages, as shown in the slide. Over the years, the Philippine IT BPM sector has been developing capabilities in not just transactional and horizontal functions, such as IT, human resources, F&A, but also in complex and core functions, including supply chain management, banking operations, marketing, and the like. This has made the Philippines an important hub for the banking, finance, services, and investment sector with the presence of many large global banks. Okay, next slide, Tin. So let's zoom in on Filipino talent. We take pride in the country's world-class quality workforce. It is without question one of the main reasons why the IT BPM industry is the economic powerhouse is today. We churn out about over 700,000 higher education graduates each year from disciplines such as business management, finance, engineering, IT, and medical healthcare information technology systems. We also have a literacy rate of 98%, one of the highest globally, and a significant population of active internet and social media users. But what truly sets the Filipino talent apart is our emphatic and customer-centric brand of service. In addition to being creative, emotive, and service-oriented, Filipinos are also known all over the world to be agile, collaborative, innovative, and resilient. Our innate affinity to other cultures also makes us highly adaptable to the needs of our clients. Next slide. So our strength has gone beyond voice, no? Undoubtedly, the Filipino talent is what propelled the Philippines to become the world's leading provider of voice services. Given this, human capital development has been and continues to be a key area of focus in sustaining the growth of the IT BPM sector and maintaining the Philippines' competitive advantage in the global marketplace. So you can see from the slide, from the traditional contact center capabilities, we have long since grown and strengthened our portfolio of non-voice services or the higher value services to include healthcare, such as pharmacovigilance, clinical trial management. On the animation part, we now have 3D animation. Under game development, we have quality assurance, game quality assurance. IT infrastructure, engineering design, and financial analysis, among others, for the other subsectors, as seen in this very busy slide. Next slide. So let's talk about 2019, our headcount and revenue growth. This pivot to higher value services has enabled us to sustain our growth momentum through the years, as demonstrated by our 2019 headcount and revenue figures. We closed last year with the number of full-time employees in the country increasing by 71,000 and registering a 5.8% growth compared to 2018. This brought our total headcount to 1.3 million Filipinos. On the right graph, the sector recorded revenues of $26.3 billion, or 7.1% jump from the previous year. These numbers show that industry growth is closer to the high range of the recalibrated figures of Roadmap 2020, and that despite global and domestic headwinds, the Philippines remains competitive, relevant, and thriving. Growth in 2019 was driven largely by existing players, which expanded not only in Metro Manila, but also in the countryside, including Bacolod, Cebu, Clark, Davao, Iloilo, and Laguna. These incumbents accounted for an additional 51,000 full-time employees nationwide. New players, were mostly global in-house centers or GICs offering a diversified range of services, including F&A, HR, procurement, and analytics. There was also particular attention to growing the number of healthcare captives. Next slide. What was our industry response to COVID-19? As we entered 2020, we were faced with a new set of obstacles that were brought about by COVID-19. Despite the less than ideal circumstances, the sector continues to demonstrate its resilience, tenacity, and enduring role as a major economic driver. The IT BPM industry was declared an essential service very soon after the lockdown began in March. It was during this period that the IT and Business Process Association of the Philippines, or IBPAP, was able to gain substantial support from the government. Agencies like the PEZA, DTI, BOI, DICT, DOLE, and NEDA, and of course, the Interagency Task Force, or the IATF. This led to special concessions for the sector to mobilize an on-site skeleton workforce and enable work-from-home operations. Over the course of the lockdown, the industry was also able to increase operational capacity while maintaining strict health protocols and providing extraordinary assistance to employees through accommodations, shuttle services, and office equipment. From just 50% at the start of the ECQ, we improved our productivity rate to 73% in May. As restrictions started to ease in June, the figure gradually went up to 90% productivity. With the unceasing support of the government, the astounding determination shown by industry leaders and the unparalleled resilience and tenacity of the workforce The sector is now operating in excess of 95% productivity through a blended service delivery model. Next slide. So, our ability to render essential services to both domestic and international clients is indeed a welcome sign of the industry's recovery. This is further reinforced by insights from the government and our allied sectors, as shown in this slide. Let's talk about investments. According to PEZA, the IT BPM industry recorded 14.146 billion pesos in investments from January to September 2020. This is 43% higher than the 9.9 billion pesos recorded for the same period in 2019. For real estate, no, the lower left-hand side of the screen, many organizations continued to identify our sector to be a prime mover of real estate. Data gathered by Lee Chu Property Consultants shows that the industry accounts for 7.2 million square meters or 48% of occupied space in the country. And although 240,000 square meters of office space was vacated between March and September 2020, this was offset by 297,000 square meters in new contracts, which were mainly driven by the BPO sector. According to the same report, 49% of the live office space requirements for the second half of 2020 comes from the IT BPO industry. This is equivalent to 482,000 square meters. Santos Knight Frank, Colliers, KMC, and CBRE share similar sentiments, with CBRE projecting that 63% of transactions in the second half of 2020 is expected to come from our sector. Let's talk about jobs. Although not business as usual yet, the IT BPM industry has been one of the few sectors that was able to remain operational during the community quarantine, providing livelihood for millions of Filipinos and their families amid the challenges of the health crisis. Opportunities within the industry actually continue to come in, just based on recent conversations we've had with different country heads and from what we've seen published in various news articles. There are over 30,000 job openings across the different subsectors. Since we're basing this off on what is only available as public information, plus select conversations with some industry leaders, we believe this number is actually higher. This is reflected in a report by JobSpeed, which shows that for the past 6 months, the IT BPM sector has been one of the top hiring industries. This is followed by the government, HR consulting, and education. Next slide. So what is the growth potential leading to 2022? So we're seeing sustained growth potential for the Philippine IT BPM industry until 2022. According to a recent study by our research partner, the Everest Group, the industry has potential to grow by a CAGR of 5.5% in revenue and 5% in headcount from 2020 to 2022. This means that the industry can reach revenues of US$29 billion by 2022 and add more than 130,000 jobs cumulatively between 2021 to 2022. To ensure that we are able to reach these growth projections, we have a number of industry-wide programs that are currently working on with partners in the government and some private sector entities. Let's go over a few of them in the next slide. Next slide, please. So we have Digital Cities 2025, which was launched in June 2020. This aims to drive inclusive growth in the countryside by selecting high potential areas throughout the country and transforming them into bustling IT BPM hubs in the next 5 years. Through the collaborative efforts done by IBPAP and DICT, we have identified 25 new locations to add on to our expanding portfolio of thriving business districts that support the IT BPM ecosystem, create jobs, spur the development of other sectors, de-risk Metro Manila concentration, and boost the local economy. As part of the Digital Cities 2025 program, the cities will receive the support of DICT, other executive agencies, local government units, industry leaders, and academic institutions. Next slide. Let me talk about national upskilling and reskilling. So in an effort to ensure that the Philippine IT BPM sector and its workforce are ready to answer the growing and shifting demands of the global marketplace, IBPAP has been focusing on an upskilling and reskilling framework that, when fully funded, is aimed at skills development for 1 million Filipinos over a period of 5 years. The National Upskilling and Reskilling Program framework focuses on three learning tracks. The first track is on domain skills learning. IBPAP has partnered with the DICT and the Development Academy of the Philippines, or DAP, in upskilling 1,000 Filipinos on top priority skills identified for animation, game development, global in-house centers, contact centers, healthcare information management, and IT and software services. We also have an initiative in the pipeline for the digital skills learning track that aims to establish partnerships with institutions and other enablers to provide upskilling programs for digital skills for the industry. Under the leadership skills learning track, the third column, IBPAP will be partnering with leadership development resource persons in conducting leadership building sessions. Next slide. So we come to the next program, which is the Talent BPM Career Awareness Fair and the Returning Overseas Filipinos Job Opportunities Program. The IT BPM Career Awareness Fair, which was launched in September 2020, is a series of virtual events that provides the IT BPM experts with a venue to talent on various career opportunities available in the sector. So far, we've had three events which were attended by over 1,000 students, job seekers, representatives from the academy and government and industry practitioners. We also have the ROF, or Returning Overseas Filipinos Job Opportunities Program, a joint initiative with the Department of Labor and Employment and the Overseas Workers Welfare Administration, or OWA. This was launched in October 2020 to help connect Filipinos displaced by COVID-19 with employment opportunities in the IT BPM sector. Currently, there are 31 companies participating in the program that is looking to fill in about 35,000 job openings. Last week, we also launched a new initiative in collaboration with Microsoft and Go Philippines called the IT BPM Skills and Knowledge Optimization Through Online Learning Program, or SCHOOL, which optimizes digital upskilling and reskilling for the industry by providing access to industry-relevant courses and industry-recognized. So with these programs, from Digital Cities to the upskilling and reskilling framework, we hope to hit our numbers in the next 2 years. That ends my presentation. And we can open the floor for some questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Attorney Salvador. For any questions, you may directly address your questions to Attorney Salvador by unmuting your mic, or you can type it in on the chat box. Sir, Attorney Ricky, there's a question here from Mr. Andy Gotuaco.
Yes.
If you can please clarify the healthcare captives and what are these?
Healthcare captives too. I have my colleague here, Carol, who can give examples of our healthcare captives and provide a, because she has worked longer with them. Carol, are you online?
Hi, good afternoon. Can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Right. So so a healthcare captive, so basically a captive first, is it's a wholly owned subsidiary of the parent company. So for example, let me start with a non-healthcare company. So P&G, Procter & Gamble, they have a captive here in the Philippines. Now, an example of a healthcare captive could be Tenet, right, which is, or Optum, which is part of the United Healthcare Group. I hope that answers your question.
Thanks, Carol. I think that's pretty extensive. I hope, yeah, we were able to answer Mr. Gotuaco's question. Thank you. Yeah, you're welcome. So I also see that we have King Mira from the House of Representatives. Good afternoon. Yes, I can. We can definitely send a copy of the presentation and access to the recording of this report care of Arangkada. We definitely be open to working with Congress. Actually, we've been invited to several meetings with Congress. There is actually a ICT block in Congress. These are attended by congressmen such as Tof de Venecia, Kiko Benitez, and the like. No, very forward-looking and progressive. Congressmen who have given us a lot of airtime explaining the IT BPM sector to the House of Representatives and what lies ahead in this sector, no? And how this sector will help the Philippines grow the economy. Yes, the IT BPM industry has about 1,300 companies in our roster, no? 800 companies are in the call center space, and the other companies, 500 companies are distributed among the other subsectors, which include animation, game development, global in-house centers, the healthcare information management, and the software industry. You're welcome. So, any other questions from the floor? So, again, thank you for the opportunity to speak during this virtual session, breakout session during the Arangkada Forum. For any questions, or if you are interested to know more about the IT BPM sector, our contact details are flashed on the screen. Our office is in BGC, but currently we just have a skeletal force there. Most of us are working from home, just like most of you. We would definitely like to hear from the participants, no? So just send us a message. At research@ibpap.com, .org, sorry. That's actually Carol. No? Carol heads our research in IBPAP and has all the figures that you may need. to make your decision. And we also have other committees, no? The LegCom, the legislatives, we also have a Labor Standards and Health Committee, among others. Any other questions, Tin? So again,
We have a question from Roy Tahale. Is there a movement trend for BPO moving outside NCR?
Yes, there is. Like 2019 figures, so the addition of incumbents, no, from outside Metro Manila, from the 71,000 additional headcount, 50,000 came from the provinces. So, and there is also the Balik Provincia program of the government, which has spurred development outside Metro Manila. And this is also supported by Digital Cities 2025, where we have identified 25 growth cities, no, outside Metro Manila. So I hope I was able to answer that question. There is really a trend. You're welcome, Froy. So as I was saying, our industry is thriving and very resilient. After the OFWs, no, remittances, the IT BPO sector is the next dollar contributor to the economy. And we hope we can reach the numbers by 2022 that we are targeting. We did $26.3 billion last year. We're hoping to hit $29 billion in the next 2 years. No? Hopefully with our imperatives and with the help of government and the private sector, we can achieve our targets. So I guess we can probably have two more minutes for this room so that will give you time to grab your coffee before the main event, no? Before joining the plenary at 1:30. Last minute questions. So I'm sure, yes. Okay, we have a question. For upskilling, are you targeting those already in the BPO industry or outside? What competencies are you looking at building? So we're targeting, no, both within and outside the industry. The returning OFWs program, so these are OFWs who we plan to reskill. No, competencies are these are the ones that the industry are looking for. These are the skills, no, in programming or even these health information management, no. So there are identified competencies, and each subsector has actually given a list. And if interested, yes, do send us an email, and we can hook you up with our talent and development director, executive director Frankie, who's very active in this space. So there's actually a lot of skills, no, in the not just in call centers, no, but also game development, global in-house centers also have skills needed, no, health information, like what I mentioned, animation. It really depends on what your skill set or what your aptitude is. There are so many opportunities in the IT BPM sector, and we hope you can check us out. So there, I think we've come to the end, no, of this session. We thank again Arrancada for inviting IBPAP. We hope to see you in our also. We also have some activities lined up for IBPAP. We just had our International Innovation Summit, but that will we're going to have that again next year for 2021. A lot of material is on our website, www.ibpap.org. Please check us out. Our materials and the latest news on the sector is there. We've posted them, and links to our social media are also in the website. So thank you very much and have a good afternoon, everyone.